Hello everyone, dear friends, today's review is about the cheapest Wi-Fi video surveillance camera for home use from the manufacturer SV3C. I think there are even cheaper cameras, but I chose the quality to be 3 megapixels, which corresponds to the quality of 2K video, as well as a wide viewing angle. In this chamber it is 100 degrees. The second criterion was the possibility of integrating the camera into the Tuya smart home system, so as not to install unnecessary applications, but to have everything in the smart home at hand. Another criterion was this power supply was 5 volts, which would allow me to power the camera autonomously from an uninterruptible power supply or power bank. Well, and the price, I didn't want to spend a lot of money for a simple camera. Let's take a closer look at all the capabilities of this camera, look at the video quality and integration options with the Tuya Smart Home and Home Assistant. Let's check the automation and the operation of all its functions. Supplied in a small cardboard box. There is no manufacturer or model logo. On one of the faces, the main advantages and capabilities of the camera are schematically depicted. On the other side there is a small sticker where we see the camera serial number and its model, C11. Although on the website of the seller of video surveillance cameras for home and street it was called TY05. Overall these are minor things. You don't have to worry about delivery, the manufacturer packed the camera securely enough. It is in a protected plastic case, plus the instructions cover the top of the camera. The instructions are quite detailed, I didn't even expect them, from connecting, setting up the camera, setting alarms for motion or sound activity, to solving most issues. Not everyone approaches the instructions for their device this way. We lift the camera and underneath it, in a neat cardboard box, there are accessories. Yes, the camera costs $10, and the kit is really great. Judge for yourself, the power supply is 5 volts 1 ampere, with a European plug already in stock. Not a small thing, but very nice. Next is the cable for connecting the camera's power. On one side there is a standard USB connector, on the other, the cable length is 1 meter. To attach the camera to the surface, a circle of double-sided tape from the manufacturer 3M is provided. There is also a triangle of past technical control. Judging by the picture on the boxes, the camera may be black. But I couldn't find it and chose white. True, there is an orange insert, I don't understand why, but so be it. The camera is really quite compact. The top is round. On the left side there is a small slot for microSD memory cards, the camera supports a capacity of up to 128 MB inclusive. On the front part, in the center, is the camera lens, and under it there is an LED indicator of the camera's operation status. Around the lens are IR LEDs for night illumination. There is a camera reset button on the back. In the center is the speakerphone speaker, and below it is a small hole for the camera's built-in speakerphone microphone. At the bottom of the camera there is a round stand with a hinge joint. This allows you not only to rotate the camera around its axis, but also to tilt it and rotate it. Even if you mount it on the wall, you can set the desired angle of tilt and rotation of the camera without any problems. The bottom stand holds the camera quite confidently even in a slightly tilted position. Yes, if you tilt it to the maximum angle, the camera will fall, so the double-sided tape included in the package will come in handy here, which we glue onto the rubberized pad of the camera stand. They decided to power the camera through the bottom stand. On the one hand, this is a good solution, since the power cable will not hang from the top of the camera. And if you plan to connect to a wall or ceiling, you can do it almost unnoticeably. On the other hand, it will not be possible to reduce the height of the leg. And the question is, if you turn the camera back and forth every day, how long will the wiring inside the leg and ball joint last? But I'm already nitpicking. Basically, the camera is installed and configured once or twice and then it just works. Specifications. Model TY05. Video resolution 3 megapixels, 2048 by 1536 pixels 2K video. Lens 4mm, viewing angle 100 degrees. Tilt angle 360 degrees left and right and rotate up and down 70 degrees. Wi-Fi connection protocol. Application for controlling Tuya Smart. Visible IR illumination. Two-way voice communication. Support motion detection notification and motion detection zone selection. Let's connect the camera to the Tuya Smart smart home system. Download and install the application on your smartphone. Register and log into your profile. Next, we put the camera into pairing mode by pressing and holding the reset button until we hear a loud beep, after 5 seconds. In the application, click the plus in the upper right corner and select the Wi-Fi camera. We agree that we have reset the device, then select your home Wi-Fi network and enter its password. After this, a QR code appears on the smartphone screen to connect and pair the camera. We bring it to the camera at a distance of 10 to 15 centimeters. You can get a little stuck here, since bright light or the wrong position of the smartphone may prevent you from reading the QR code correctly. After you hear the beep signal from the camera, you need to press the "I heard the prompt" button on the smartphone screen. After a few seconds, the camera will be added to the Tuya Smart smart home ecosystem. From the main screen, we only have access to the camera shortcut. To watch video from one camera or multiple cameras at once, go to the Smart Protect tab at the top of the application. Here you can immediately view video from cameras and manage security and alarm modes. Let's go inside the plugin, as we see the image from the camera is immediately displayed. By turning the smartphone into tablet mode, the picture is automatically stretched to fill the entire smartphone screen, convenient for more detailed viewing. In addition, you can bring the picture a little closer by zooming in with two fingers. This works in both tablet and standard orientation. At the top, you can select the quality of the transmitted image. This does not affect the quality of recording to a memory card or to the cloud. HD or SD is how the picture is displayed on a smartphone, and if the data transmission channel is weak, then you can select SD. By default, the sound of the camera transmission is turned off. You can listen to what is happening around the camera by activating the speaker icon. Below it is an indication of the current data transfer speed. If in this camera display mode you don't like the stripes at the top and bottom, click on the icon and the image will be adjusted to the height of your display, but you will have to move it horizontally. At the bottom there is a small menu. Here we can immediately convert the image from the camera to tablet view by clicking on the square. You can take a photo with your camera. Activate the smartphone microphone to transmit sound to the camera speaker. We can also start recording the current situation from the camera. The budget is recorded directly into the smartphone and stored in its memory. This will not affect recording to the memory card or the Tuya cloud service in any way. Then we can access the extended menu. Here we can view the video that is saved on the camera's memory card. You can select a day and rewind the time. In the gallery menu, you can view all the photos and videos saved on your smartphone from this particular camera. It's convenient if you have a lot of them, but you need to look at one and not confuse them. Next, you can choose a dark or light theme. If the camera is installed in the bedroom or, say, in the guest room and guests have arrived, then the camera can be switched to sleep mode. To do this, simply click on the private mode button and the camera goes to sleep. You can reactivate the work by clicking on the blue enable camera link. We can also activate the motion detection function. Then the message menu will receive a notification about motion detection in the camera's visibility range. This motion notification will also appear in the notification shade and in notifications. By clicking on the edit button, we can add a shortcut for management. For example, if there is motion detection, turn on the relay into which you connect the siren. Or turn off the lights if the child being watched by the camera falls asleep. Quite a convenient feature. You can activate a cloud video storage subscription and activate artificial intelligence to work with this camera. Services are paid. In global settings, you can view information about the device, a unique ID and IP address of your network, indicating the strength of the Wi-Fi signal. You can put the camera into sleep mode. In the basic camera settings, you can activate image rotation by 180 degrees. This will allow you to install the camera upside down, for example on the ceiling. You can also disable the time and date stamp, and also set the microphone operating mode. By default, you need to hold down the microphone button to transmit sound. You can activate the sound to be transmitted immediately when you press the microphone button, and pressing it again deactivates this function. In the motion detection settings, additional settings are activated after enabling this function. Here you can set the sensitivity level from minimum to maximum. And also select either everything that falls within the camera's field of view, or select an area for motion detection. You cannot specify more than one area, but the presence of such a function in a budget camera is also a plus. Additionally, you can specify a schedule for activating motion detection, which is also a plus. For example, if you left for work, the camera will switch to security mode automatically, and when you come home the function will be disabled. You can activate cloud storage and notifications on your smartphone. Features are paid. There were no updates at the time of recording the review. The firmware version was 1.1.37.291. You can activate the auto update feature. The camera can be connected to an IPC client for PC. There is a separate hint on how to do this. Let's see what the camera can do in terms of automation. Let's go to the script and add a new one. We find and select our camera. Here we can create automation for motion detection. If the camera detects movement, turn on the lights in all rooms. That is, we will have the camera as a trigger for automation. But at the same time, she cannot participate in automation herself. For example, we select the time and select automation for the device. And as you can see, cameras are not on the list here. So the camera is only a trigger for other devices. Let's see what the camera can do in the Home Assistant smart home ecosystem. Let's go inside our smart home, go to integrations and find the Tuya integration. We update the list of devices and go inside. We find our camera, here it is a Wi-Fi camera. Inside we see from the sensors the current picture and the current status, recording. We can add this to the dashboard. The current picture is transmitted completely correctly. It's dark here now. Next in the configuration we can flip the image. Enable motion detection and select trigger sensitivity. Enable motion recording. Turn off the camera. Change the operating mode, now the permanent recording operating mode is set. We can set up recording only by motion detection. Also remove or install the date and time watermark. And turn video recording on or off. There is also a log of our camera's operation. When it was on and when it was off. Let's see what's on our Wi-Fi camera. As you can see, the image from the camera is fully transmitted, time passes, which means the Home Assistant system fully supports it. Tests. Since I bought the camera for home use, how many amperes does it consume? Let's check it out. Here is the standard operating mode of 0.3 amperes. But the night mode is 0.35 amperes. As you can see, even if you connect it to a simple power bank, its power will be enough for a long battery life of the camera. Even when there is no Wi-Fi connection, the camera records everything on the installed microSD memory card. This is how the camera films in a room during the day.
Привет, вот так снимаю камера. Я стою. Действительно, группа обзора достаточно большого. Почти всю большую комнату, она длиной 10 метров, ширина вернее. Практически всю ее видит. И вот я стою сейчас, стою здесь, где-то метр от камеры. Да, метр от камеры. И получается, слева у меня метров 6, наверное. И справа метра 4.
An example of video shooting in the evening with lighting.
Вот такое немножко освещение есть. Вот так снимает камера. Ну, освещение просто вот такое дежурное, оно кажется. Потому что при свете вы уже видели, как это снимается. Ну, вот, как-то так.
And here is an example of night photography, illuminated only by the camera's IR LEDs.
Полная темнота, вот так вот, в принципе, выглядит. Ну, вот, это я не буду снимать смартфон, а подсвечивать.
If you just right-click, the file properties will be empty. This confused me a little and I decided to check further. Open the file using media info. And what we see? Resolution 1920 by 1080 pixels. This is 2 megapixels. The number of frames is 20 per sec. Well, at least it's not bad. The memory card is recorded in chunks of about 5 minutes. 5 minutes of video is 24.4 megabytes of memory on the memory card. Let's try to open the parameters through VLC player. The same thing, resolution 1920 by 1080 pixels. As you can see, there is no talk about 3K video, although I was mentally prepared for this, but it's worth demanding a refund from the seller for incorrect information. Let's summarize. For such a cheap camera, it has quite a lot of features and settings, I'm even a little surprised. For its price, this is quite a normal result for home video surveillance. A fairly wide viewing angle, good recording quality and night mode operation are advantages. Another advantage is the ability to configure the motion detection mode with the ability to select a detection zone. Putting the camera into sleep mode is also a plus, it doesn't always need to work. The quality of sound transmission is also without any comments. And the fact that the package immediately includes a power supply and you get a device completely ready for use is even two pluses. I didn't like the fasteners a little, namely the long leg and limited ball joint. Since I want to attach the camera to the wall, and the ball's movement does not quite allow this, we'll have to come up with another option for mounting the camera, or slightly modify the ball joint by increasing the travel of the camera leg. And the deception in the description from the seller that this is a camera with 3 megapixel shooting is also a minus. Even a big minus, since after the purchase I only found 2 reviews about HD quality, not 2K. Buyers see the picture, it is generally not bad, and all 5 stars. So look at not only positive but also negative reviews, and my reviews, I always try to tell you about all the products in as much detail as possible. I hope the video was useful to you and was able to reveal all the capabilities of this smart camera. Please don't forget to like the video if you liked it and subscribe to the channel so you don't miss other interesting videos about smart and not so smart home systems. All links to products can be found in the description under the video. There is also a link to a Telegram group where you will find not only new products on the smart home system, but also interesting smart home products, discounts, coupons, and promotions. There is also a link to a Telegram group structured by forum topics for communication and resolving issues related to a smart home. All the best to everyone, peaceful skies and goodness. Bye bye.